So first question, as historian, you'll have to attend almost or all BSA events. How committed do you think you will be in that goal or in that job?
I understand the importance of that commitment because since it's listed in the bylaws and I physically have to be there to complete my tasks, I believe I'm very committed because I have attended most GBMs and most internal events that I could do this year and a couple of externals as well. Of course, I hope to improve that in the future, but I believe I'm very committed. And in the case where I can't physically be there, I will assign my task to someone I know who can use a camera and who I know is responsible enough, and then I will take that and continue to do my other tasks like editing the video or uploading the photos.
So what type of camera do you own? And what kind of software do you have to edit videos?
Currently, I don't own my own camera, but my dad is a photographer and he's given me his old camera. I just need to buy a lens for it, so I do have preparations for that. I know I borrowed other people's equipment this year, but I do have means to get my own. For video editing, I use Adobe Premiere, which I used for Wildfire. I used to use a different program, but I hope to learn more about this program.
Awesome. And say you were going to edit a recap. What would you do if you lost all of your footage? Like for example, if your SD card got corrupted or was broken, what would you do in the case that it does? And what can you do to prevent this?
This actually kind of happened to me this year for the Smash video. Some of the content, it just didn't load onto my laptop, so I didn't have as much footage as I wanted to work with. But fortunately, I had some footage on my phone because the camera I was using was like about to die. So I had extra footage that I took on my phone just in case. So I was able to use that to make the video that I wanted to make. So I learned to just be prepared and be prepared to have backups and backups for your backups. So I hope to use my phone as a backup. And then I just hope to be more, to be responsible to make sure to prevent that from happening in the first place.
Awesome.
Okay, this will be the last prepared question, and then we'll open it up to whoever's on the floor. How would you, as a historian, try to involve both active and inactive members?
So when I mentioned I wanted to portray people in the best version of themselves, I forgot to mention it, but I hope to talk to every GBMer that I can and to have them come out, have them participate, and just inspire them to do that. As for if it's like a certain event where someone's not having a great time or something like that, I know that I'm not in CAB alone. I know everyone else is with me. So I hope to reach out to other CAB members and try to have them kind of involve that person, and then I can just make a picture of that person. That's how I'll work on having every member get involved.
Excellent. Okay. Any questions from the floor? Going once? Oh, sorry.
So,
Mel and then John.
Okay. As an art major myself, I know how time consuming studio classes can be. What is your schedule look like for next semester, and how do you expect to manage your time with your projects as well as like editing videos and content for BSA and attending their events?
My schedule for next year, I don't really know the specifics yet, but I'm planning on taking the same number of studio classes as I am this semester, which is 2 studio classes. So yeah, that does take a lot of time, but coming as an intern, I learned from my mistakes regarding time management, and I know that my responsibilities as a student does come before that of my extracurriculars. So I learned how to manage my time through trial and error this way. So I hope to improve that and stay committed to the responsibilities of BSA. So yeah, type commitment class-wise, it should be the same as this semester. So
thank you. And John?
It's just the issue of how are you going to deal with having so many photos and you don't upload it on time? Like, how will you prevent that from happening?
Prevent?
From uploading photos and videos late.
Well, for me personally, I know how I can sit, how I can manage my time and complete tasks the most personally. So if I kind of, some things I like to hold off, not gonna lie, but for things that I'm passionate about, I get it done right away. So for example, for the bonfire video, like as soon as we got home, I like download, like, and then the next morning I downloaded the videos. So because I'm really like excited about, you know, making videos, uploading content, that's something I'm passionate about. So I can confidently say I don't have any issues like procrastinating for tasks such as uploading videos on time, uploading photos on time, because I want everyone to enjoy them. And if it's late, then people will be like, ooh, why it's late? So yeah, I want people to enjoy them. So I'll be sure to complete them on time.
Excellent. Any final questions before we move on? Awesome. Thank you.